Hi, welcome to another episode of TechSmith Tips. In this episode, I'm going to try to help you understand different video file types and recommend which ones will work best for you. Now, as our TVs and computer screens continue to increase in size, the evolution of efficient file types that work well on these machines is only natural. .mp4, .mov, .avi, .h.264, .mpeg4, AVCHD, these are all video file types you may have heard of or seen before. Now, when thinking about file types, the top three things you need to consider are video quality, file size, and compatibility. The first topic I want to cover is lossy versus lossless file formats. When I say these terms, I'm referring to how much compression is happening when you create a video file. Now, a lossy file format means that a file is losing quality when it is compressed because it is an approximation of the original file. A lossless file type means that the image is being compressed but can be perfectly reconstructed. The most common and widely accepted video format used today is the lossy .mp4 file type. Now, this file type is popular because it keeps your video at a high quality with a low file size. Plus, it's compatible with almost all video editors and operating systems, meaning it'll play nice with almost every piece of hardware and software out today. Another good rule of thumb is to never convert lossy files to lossless. Doing so can ruin your file's quality and make the file size unnecessarily large. Okay, so the last topic. I want to cover the differences between a codec and a container. The simplest way I can describe the difference is that a codec is the method used to compress the data, and the container is basically how the file is delivered over the internet. For example, remember the .mp4 file type I've been talking about? Well, that .mp4 refers to the container used. The codec, which is the process in charge of compressing, is called H.264. Now, people refer to codecs and containers often interchangeably, and there are literally hundreds of combinations between them. You just have to make sure you refer to the right ones. Now, I know this is a lot to understand. It can be super confusing, but the important item to take away from this is that the MP4 file format is your friend. You should always try to use it when you're sharing videos on the web. And as always, comment, like, share, and ask your questions below. See you next time.